last time on Great Southern Travellers.
We are gods on the track.
G'day, and welcome to Great Southern Travellers.
I'm Emma.
And I'm Joe.
We've recently given up our jobs and started on our lap of Australia.
Dive in and join us every Thursday for the adventure.
Oh yeah, so we are at the Peak Hill Open Mine. I'm going to have a look around. It's a pretty lovely day. Driven here from Dubbo this morning about an hour, not all 40 so minutes, not too bad. We're going to go have a little wander through the grass. The pictures look amazing, so hopefully it looks better in person. What do you think, Mrs. Smith?
I'm going deeper underground, I'm going... I think it's a really interesting sight. There's you don't get to see many big open casts like this too often, do you? I mean, we spent a bit of time in Gold Country, kind of not that far away, in Orange and Mudgee, that sort of way.
I've never quite seen one like this.
It wasn't quite like
this,
yeah.
Just you feel like you are just on the precipice of it.
So gold was first discovered here in 1889 in sort of core deposits that were pulled out of the ground. And this actually blast pattern in the open mine was only actually created and excavated in 1996 to 2001, which feels super recent. I mean, it only stopped about 21 years ago. But here we are looking at a mine site that was active 20 years ago. Go figure.
Heading south towards Parkes, we enjoyed some of the highlights on the way, not least the Dish, famous for its role supporting Apollo 11, finally putting man on the moon, and the Sam Neill film of the same name. Perfect, right? I don't know about you, but I thought that was pretty good looking. Really, really dishy. Well, bless my soul, what's wrong with me? I'm itching like a man on a fuzzy tree. My friends say I'm acting queer as a duck, I'm in love. I'm all shook up. Ooh-hoo. When you've done Gold Kong, you don't need to go to the Henry Parkes Pioneer Museum. Sorry, Henry. Looks like a lovely old boy, but not the place for us today.
After exploring Forbes for the afternoon, we set up camp by the river.
So,
beautiful campsite just outside of the town. You can walk across the bridge. Took about what, 15 minutes?
Yeah, about 15 minutes.
About 15 minutes.
Speaking of gorgeous,
what do you think?
It's pretty cool, eh? I don't know how many old gold towns with old historic stations we can actually visit, but, you know, we're getting close.
This one's actually quite cute, I think.
Quite cute, isn't it? The Kuruwatha line closed in the early 90s, so the Lions Club decided to make this a tourist destination with barbecues and toilets and everything picked up, I guess. For RV use, so for people like ourselves travelling through, so there's somewhere to camp here. It's got the toilets, it's got the barbecues, it's got some bins, it's got a dump point, so. Great, I love these old historic signs for the stations. They're always my favourite.
What do you reckon?
It's pretty beautiful. It's also huge. I mean, you don't really realise from the car how big it is compared to like a person.
Quick, go and stand by the silo.
Yeah.
Pretty big. So big I can't get it and Emma in the shot.
When we left Forbes, we made our way across from Forbes through to Young, through Grenfell.
The cherry capital of Australia.
Yeah.
So we explored a little bit, took a picture at the big cherries.
And then went on to Cootamundra, but very briefly. Cootamundra is famous for Don Bradman, the Australian cricketer, and as a Kiwi and a Pom, not really our jam.
Yeah.
Not what we're about.
Not Australian cricketers, no, not really.
No, so we actually went and camped up by Bathungra Dam, which was...
beautiful spot, right on the dam. We went for a dip the next morning, not too fresh actually, just really lovely, just nice to get a chance to relax and unwind after some of the driving of the past couple of days.
I think we were a little bit higher as well, so we had some really nice kind of cooler weather come through in the evening.
And after Bathungra Dam, we wound our way through to Wagga.
Yeah, via where?
Oh, Junie Licorice and Chocolate Factory.
This is a secret place. Anyone that's kind of been to the Riverina has heard about this. Seen anything on Visit New South Wales or like this, but Junie Chocolate and Licorice Factory is gorgeous and we haven't even been inside yet.
Now, your favourite place on our trip so far.
If you're going to stop anywhere, I highly recommend the Junie Licorice and Chocolate Factory. You can actually watch them make the chocolate on site where they've developed an old mill into making this chocolate and licorice factory. Just beautiful, family owned, gorgeous. They've just done it in such a lovely way.
Show us what you do.
He's so
cute.
I think the best hot chocolate I've ever had. It's dark chocolate. We're having breakfast. We've got a hot chocolate. I'm not massively into licorice, but you know what chocolate and licorice can do? Especially if it comes in the hot chocolate. What have we got?
Frogs. Chocolate block. Happy Valentine's Day.
Next time on Great Southern Travellers. If you like this video, like, comment, and subscribe.